Simon and Garfunkel albums were a regular feature at the top of the charts. With their next project, though, they graduated to international superstardom.
And here's to you, Mrs. Robinson. Jesus loves you more than you will know.
Here we are. You got me into your house. You give me a drink. You put on music. Now you start opening up your personal life to me and tell me your husband won't be home for hours.
So?
Mrs. Robinson, you're trying to seduce me.
Paul said, Mike Nichols has called me. He's filming The Graduate.
Aren't you?
And he was living with the slots that he wanted the Simon and Garfunkel music to be in without having the songs written yet. And I said to Mike, Paul was writing a song called Mrs. Roosevelt that he's despairing of.
Oh, God. Oh, let me out.
Don't be nervous.
And Mike said to me, I can't believe that you've written a song and you haven't told me about it. So I said, well, I haven't really decided. Should it be Mrs. Robinson or should it... Sometimes I sing, Here's to You, Mrs. Roosevelt.
Here's to you, Mrs. Roosevelt.
And he said, come on, are you kidding? We're working on The Graduate. It's got to be Mrs. Robinson. That seems so apparent when Mike said it.
He said, well, we got to have that. That's perfect.
Except that I'd only written the chorus in time for the movie.
We showed him the chorus, that's all that was written, and he said, it's perfect.
And here's to you, Mrs. Robinson. Jesus loves you more than you will know. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Stand up tall, Mrs. Robinson. God in heaven smiles on those you pray. Hey, hey, hey.
Just as Dustin was grafting a New York Jewish sensibility into a surfboard world, so was, to some extent, Simon and Garfunkel. Paul's lyrics and music and Paul and Artie's voices were so much about longing.
Sitting on the windowsill near the flowers. We might as well be apart. It hardly matters, we sleep separately. And drop a smile. passing in the hall, but there's no laughs left, 'cause we laughed them all. And we laughed them all in a very short time. Time is tapping on my forehead, hanging from my mirror, rattling the teacups, and I wonder how long can I delay? Just a habit like saccharin, and I'm habituated feeling kind of blue. But each time I try on the thought of leaving you, I stop and think it over.
We always had the impression of you that you were really quite a melancholy person, and there's always a plaintive note to those early hits, wasn't there?
Well, you know, I think I actually was more melancholy in, when I was in my 20s. But there's something about Simon and Garfunkel success. It was an enormous thing to absorb. But it, of course, within the work process, within the recording, and in my relationship with Artie, we had a lot of fun. We had a lot of laughs.
Wish I was an English muffin, got to make the most out of a toaster. I'd ease myself down. And very more than any ordinary jam. I'm a Citizens for Boys and very jam fan.
On their park bench like bookends, a newspaper blown through the grass falls on the round toes of the high shoes of the old friends. Old friends, winter companions, the old men lost in their overcoats, waiting for the sunset. The sounds of the city sift through the trees, settle like dust on the shoulders of the old friends.
We had very good years in 65, 6, 7, 8. At 69, I think we had been traveling so much together and we were so forced to be together. It began to tell on our friendship, which was always true. It always was what it is. We would never let ourselves be forced into a friendship because it works or anything. So because it was always either true or nothing, it began to be abrasive, to be so forced together and tour.